Welcome to our next video of our Selenium C# with MSTest Framework in our Lambda Test video series. And in this video, we'll be talking about how we can write a super simple Selenium test using MSTest Framework. In our last video, we created a simple MSTest project using the MSTest .NET Core project template of Visual Studio 2019. And in this video, we'll be seeing how we can start writing the code within Selenium C#. So for adding a Selenium dependency, we are going to be right-clicking this packages and we'll be adding a NuGet package where we can search for Selenium. So once we search for Selenium, we get the Selenium webdriver over here. So let's try to install the Selenium webdriver and this will add the dependency for us. And at the same time, since we'll be using different browsers, for instance, for this demonstration, we'll be using the Chrome browser, we need to install the Chrome driver as well. So we'll be installing this Chrome driver alongside so that we can invoke the Chrome browser within our Selenium test that we'll be executing. And once these two dependencies are added, we're pretty good to go with writing the Selenium test on this test method. So the code that we'll be writing this time for Selenium test is going to be available mostly in our Lambda Test GitHub repo. So if you search for any project related to Selenium C#, let's say Selenium C#, you can get into the C# NUnit Selenium or NUnit Selenium sample. So if you go to any of our project and if you just go to the project and any of our test, you will find a lot of test which is going to be related to one of the application that we'll be using prevalently for testing and showcasing a demo. So we'll be using the same application this time as well to see how we can automate the application. And you can see that the application is going to be the lambdatest.github.io sample to-do app. So we'll be using the same application to automate and we'll be copy-pasting some of the codes from here. So to start writing the Selenium test, the first thing that we need to do is to create the iWebDriver of driver, which can be accessible from the global scope. And because this iWebDriver needed to be added a reference, we'll be adding by using the control dot of Visual Studio shortcut. And then we'll be using this openqa.selenium to add the Selenium dependency. And once we have this dependency, then we can start writing the code. So the first code that we'll be doing is opening a new Chrome browser or the Chrome driver to start playing with the driver that we'll be using. So I'm going to be adding the dependency using the openqa.selenium.chrome and this will add the Chrome dependency for us. And then we need to navigate to the website using the go-to URL of the application that we just saw, which is going to be this one. So we can just copy this and we can paste it over here. And then we can start writing the rest of the code, which is going to be clicking the checkboxes and adding the button and things, which is going to be something like this. So this is the way that we can write a super simple code of Selenium, which is going to start performing the operation for us. So let's try to run this code and see how this code is actually going to be working for us. So I'm just going to right click this test method. And once I hit this run, it is going to start invoking a Chrome browser for us. And then it is going to run the test for us as well. So as you can see, it has opened a browser for us and then it has completed the full test execution successfully. But with the MSTest framework, we can do a lot more thing. As you can see, once the test has been executed, the browser was not closed, which means the driver was not quit after the test execution, which we can do using the TestCleanUp attribute of MSTest framework to do it for us. So we can just call this public void cleanup or any method name of your choice. And then we can just do driver.quit to quit the browser for us. And in fact, we can do even more things. For example, if we want to have the Chrome driver in the test initialize, we can move from the test and then we can write the test initialize attribute of MSTest framework to do it for us. So we can just call it as initialize. And we can copy paste the code over here. So you can see that the initialization is going to be initializing the driver for us and the cleanup is going to quit the driver for us. And this test method is going to be responsible just for executing the test for us. So let's try to run this test once again and we'll see how the test is going to be behaving for us. And as you can see, the browser has been opened and it also got quit once the test cleanup is being called and the test has been successfully completed. So this way, we can easily run Selenium test using MSTest framework of Selenium using Selenium C#. In our next video, we'll see how we can extend this operation to run a parallel test execution using MSTest framework and using Selenium's remote web driver. Thank you.
As always, please post any questions in the comments below or at community.lambdatest.com. See you in the next video.